Okay, hello, welcome everybody. Today I'm going to be painting this Hanuman mask that my husband 3D printed. So let me just get the stream up. Alright, so this is a 3D printing post-processing, and so let's just take a look. Before I can start painting, there are some cracks here, as you can see, some spaces that are not meeting. So you see that right over there. So, and there's a little bit of a hole right in there, right here. So what I have here is some air-dried clay, modeling clay, some of this. Okay, and I have opened this, but I put it back in a bag so it doesn't get... Okay, I'm gonna put some gloves on because this is gonna get right under my nails. Okay. I'm gonna get a little bit of this. Let me see. Maybe move this camera a bit this way. I don't know why the camera is not very in focus. Okay, I'm gonna grab some clay. Push it in to cover the seam. Okay, I'm gonna push from the other side. So much from the other side, from the back. Here we want it to be nice and even. I've never worked with this kind of clay before. It's a little bit different than what I was expecting. More crumbly than I thought. I'm gonna grab a brush to clean it up a little bit. Got some gunk in its ear. All right, that's good over there. Okay, let's do it on the other side where there's also a big gap. Not even going in. Okay. Let's try it from this side. So this mask was printed in two parts, obviously. In two pieces. Okay, there we go. That's pretty good. Let me fill those little holes there. Just pushing it from this side, and I'll smooth it from the other side. There we go. And okay, grabbing that brush. There we go. Nice, and nobody will ever know. Well, the hole opened. Let me just stick it in. Alright, that's okay. It's not gonna be seen through all the layers of paint, I don't think. Let me reseal this. Put it back in the Ziploc bag. All right. So now I can start painting. I've got a Stay Wet palette over here. Trying to move this so you can have a better view. All right. So I have craft paints from Arteza. I have a gold. I'm gonna need quite a bit of gold for the crown. I'll start with the skin color for the face. And then move on to the beard, and then I'll do the crown. So I have the espresso brown. Let me shake it. I haven't used this in a while. Quite a bit. I want to have enough. So I'll start with the brown and add some pink. I don't have a white with me, so just try to make a, you want to see the mixing session is always quite satisfying. And I wanted some orange. Let's see what this makes. This is gonna be a decent skin color or something really weird. Or both. Well, it's very brown. I want it a little lighter. I don't have any white. Or if I do, it's kind of hidden away. I need to lighten it up. Put some more. Oh, this is red. Ah, I had the orange here. It's lightening up slowly. I think I should have started with the light colors and then just added a little bit of brown. Anyway, we're gonna be adding multiple layers, so I can always lighten the top layer. Besides, this can be, I can divide this in half, and half of it I can use for the beard, and half for the skin. So that's actually a really good idea. Just start the skin color a little bit this way. It's pretty orangey. Just a little bit more pink. Here we go. Okay, let's start with that for the face. I'm gonna get a fluffy paintbrush. All right, let's get to it. So here's the mask, if you want to see it in all of its glory. It's pretty big. It's huge, actually. This is my hand. Big, big, big mask. Need light over here. All right, so let's do it. So this is craft paint, which means it's gonna stick on the plastic a lot better than other kinds of acrylic paint. And hopefully it'll dry fast. Not really worried if I get into other spaces with my skin color. I'm gonna go with a smaller paintbrush there next to the teeth and the other edges. Trying to get some paint into those seams where the two pieces meet, make it a little more seamless. Oh, now I'm just doing the base coat. I'll probably add more kind of colors in side next to the eye, next to the mouth, the teeth. So this is a good just base coat, first layer to start with. I'm gonna get as close as I can. I think I'm gonna change to a smaller brush now. Trouble with small brushes is that they hold a very small amount of paint, but they can get a lot closer to an edge. All right, the first layer is always, you know, the first layer. Now it looks a lot more like what it's supposed to be, since we only have there. That's better already, except for the shine, which will dry flat matte, so I wouldn't worry about it. And there we go. To the teeth. Well, I'm gonna need white paint. Hang on. I'm going to need the white have white paint or craft paint, not that I can see, so I'm just gonna use Liquitex and mix it with the craft. craft. We do what we can. I'm just gonna mix it with some of this brown so that it's not pure white, because teeth aren't really pure white. Just give it a little bit of a color. Kind of like ivory white. Just mixing that white. Okay, let's see. Let's see how white they are. They're pretty white. Oh, bring some more brown in. Block in the beard now. The beard's gonna be just a brownish. I'm just gonna add some brown to that initial skin color that I mixed. Let's see how it looks. Yeah, that's all right. It's pretty dark. Oh, I didn't paint his ear. Gotta get his ear. The skin color. Thank you. See this?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. a look at him. Yeah, looks better. Looks better already. Okay, let's clean up some things here. Patching some things. All right, overall it's pretty even. I'm gonna get clean up the crown here. Crown's gonna be gold, so I don't want dark paint underneath it. Just wiping off with a dry clean brush. Well, kind of, relatively dry and clean. Clean it up. There we go. Now let's do the ears. Just fix some things here. Using the smaller brush. A little bit of orange in. Ears maybe have a more of a reddish appearance. Just a tad of orange. We'll see how it looks afterwards. Gotta be careful around that seam that I just patched because the clay might still be a little bit wet. Just nice and easy around there. It looks good so far. some more orange. Oh, I can't see the live chat on my computer. Hey, Miss W, I didn't see you there. Good morning. I just refreshed my computer. I turned on my phone. That's what you look like in the morning. That's weird. I don't know why I'm not seeing the comments on the laptop. Ah, now I do. I refreshed it. That's good. I was thinking it's unusual. It's so quiet. I mean, it's not unusual. It's just wanted to make sure that the machines aren't glitching. Pretty mighty beard for the first thing in the morning. Alright, so now I'm just going to stick my finger in its eye and start priming the crown with some gold. Alright, the gold from Arteza. Open it up. Something's not right here. See, that's why I like wearing gloves. Sometimes you're just faced with situations like these. And getting paint on yourself is inevitable. Lots of gold. So gold is generally more transparent than other paints. It's gonna need a bunch of layers. Yeah, it's very transparent. It just means that it's gonna need a lot of layers. Thinking 4 or 5 layers of gold. Here's hoping that it dries fast. Try not to leave too much paint in the creases. Hope that subsequent layers will be a little more thick. gonna do the gold in the back too. It's a little bit difficult to hold. Guys can see. There we go. It's a little bit easier. I can do that. Oh, just run out of gold. Thankfully, I have two tubs of gold. That's good. All right, let me just the back. Just a lot of paint here. And then just spreading it. There we go. Slowly, slowly, it's starting to come together. Get a small round paintbrush to do this. It looks a lot more gold in the video than it is in reality. In reality, it's a lot more transparent, and it is gold, but there's a lot of transparency happening. Alright, let's give the skin another color. I'm actually gonna look up. I'm gonna look up a chimpanzee to see the difference in colors in the skin. Thank you. second layer of paint. What just happened? The phone just died. The webcam. It just died. Isn't it plugged in? Hang on. Just bear with me. I think. It says it's charging, I think. I don't know why it died. It's gonna be a while until my picture comes back, probably. Sure that it's charging. I'm not sure that it is. Well, it turned on. I don't know if it's going to be able to sustain the camera. All right, now let's give it another try. Let's see. I think it's okay. It's good so far. I'm back. I have a tag. Like, is it a spider or is it a tag? I'm trying to hide the seam with paint. Alright, I'm gonna start darkening the skin a little bit, going upwards, just around the eyes a little bit. Just a little bit darker, not a lot. Going back into the light, just kind of creating a smooth transition, smooth gradient. So I want it to be light again on top. Changing to a smaller brush, getting into the smaller areas. Maybe I should darken inside his nose, nostril a little bit. I will, in a little bit. Getting in there. Go even darker, right inside next to the eyes, right in there. Getting a little darker right inside the nostril. And then getting some light paint to blend it out. Looks pretty good, but I want to give it another coat. Let's get the teeth first. Thank you. Go back into the beard. Let me just make the beard details first. Hey Stanley. Hey buddy, what's up? What's up, Stanley? You gotta go outside? Is that what you want? I don't know. Didn't you go outside? Okay. I didn't get his near the ear skin. Let's do his beard again. It's gonna be a really quick go. Plus his beard is already looking pretty decent, pretty good. beard is done. Pretty sure I have full coverage now. Okay, now it's time for the crown again. I think I'm gonna use a smaller brush, a softer brush. I think this is slightly softer. I gotta get more gold.
Thank you.
It's slowly getting more opaque. It's really getting coverage, which is good. Maybe we don't need four layers. Maybe just three will be enough on the crown. Maybe even two. I don't know. We'll see how it dries. It is going a lot thicker than the first layer. Just get into under here. Make sure that everything is nice and neat and clean. go. Now I need to clean the ear. Where I got gold on it. Okay, and now I need to get it back. Okay, let's get the gold parts first. Just gonna do the rest of the crown in gold. And then the rest will just be a dark brown. Initially it was supposed to be black, but I don't think I have... It's okay, Gil, it's okay. I don't think I have black. Have the first... Careful, Gil. What are you doing? I got tangled in my headphones. Just do brown, and then if it's not dark enough, we'll put a layer of black on top of that, but I think this will be fine. So me refine this ear here. There we go. Got some dark paint coming out of the nose. Assess the situation. Well, he looks pretty good. I think before I add the different colors to the crown, I'm gonna add another maybe I can do it now. Add another layer to the of gold. Let's just get it done now. And then maybe I can finish it. I just love to see the layers of paint become more opaque and more like gold. Beating that transparency. Just looks more solid. Which is what we're going for. We want it to look like solid gold, not like painted plastic. Okay. I think we are at the point where we can do the crown. Fancy. I didn't think that I'll have time today, but here we are. Just gonna fix one last thing. Not fix, just retouch. Here we go. Okay. Let's get to business. I'm getting a small brush and have an iridescent green. It's very pretty. I'm gonna do this leaf with the green. Maybe I'll just use a liner brush. Nice and soft, it leaves a lot of color behind. Although I do want this to be transparent, so maybe I should use a different brush. The gold has to be seen through. Okay, just that will be gold, and then around. Then I'm using the. Where is it? Where did I put it? This pretty bright metallic paint from Deco Art. Oh, hey, Ann Jan! Hi! How are you doing, Anjan? Haven't seen you since Christmas. Since Christmas? It's been a while. The ape is upside down. Yeah, so that I can paint the crown, because I need to paint the crown. It was a great time. Finding puzzle pieces. That's funny. It was all Sam's idea. It was fun. We figured something, some activity that we can all do together. Thank you. Got plans for the weekend? Everybody's okay. Amethyst, I have to go and get her soon from school because she's got a play. She does crew for theater, for play at her school. They're doing Les Misérables, so she's part of the crew from 10 to 2, so I need to go pick her up soon. And Sam's just doing his thing in the den, and I'm over here just painting his ape. He 3D printed this and now I'm painting it. Just trying to keep busy, you know. I mean, we're not even trying, it's just life. How about you guys? You and your very vast network of friends and family. Hey, the pups are good. You know, the old one is here next to me. Is down there with his legs spread out. He's good. He's getting better. He had a little accident before the new year and, you know, traumatized us all. I mean, especially himself. But he's better now. How's Moo Moo? Yep. Yes, we are. Wait, is Moo Moo trying? Ah, Moo is fabulous. Well, send some love her way. It was so sweet to see her so animated. Last time, I've never seen her so friendly. It was really surprising. Very nice. But generally, she's just keeping to herself. Last time, she was actually friendly. I'm like, ooh. Nice. Oh my goodness, 2-pound jar. Not broken. Whew. Buying yourself some butt bubble wrap. Oh, you're a danger to yourself. How'd you even get 2 pounds of peanut butter? Hopefully it was in a plastic jar. 2 pounds. It must have hurt. I've dropped heavy things on my foot. Generally glass jars. Yeah, I definitely bruised it several times, but you didn't break it. Yeah, that's good. A plastic jar. I do have plastic jars from Costco peanut butter. Costco peanut butter? That happens. You know what happens actually? I mean, if it's a plastic jar, sometimes I let it fall, but if it's anything hard that can hurt the floor or that can break, I stop it with my foot purposefully, you know, so it doesn't break. So, you know, I just have to remind myself not to do that with knives. Not to stop things with my foot with knives. I think I've done that before, but thankfully the blade did not get me. No knives. Fell out of your hand and you couldn't get out of the way. Right. Well, you're lucky enough to get old. You're lucky enough to get old. Well, you know how fast time passes. It's just... before you know it. How's my mom? She's good. You know, surviving. Surviving Romania. She's good. You know, so we're expecting packages from each other from before Christmas, because we always send packages to each other around Christmas time so that it arrives there. Well, I generally send it too late and it arrives after New Year's, even though I send it at the beginning of December. Well, this time I sent it before her. It was November 28th and she sent it on December 3rd, I think. And her packages arrive to me way faster. It just takes like 2 weeks. Well, this year, I'll tell you that neither of us got our packages yet. They're stuck. Mine was stuck in... the one that I sent her was stuck in Belgium for like more than a month. It's finally in Romania, but it's in transit. Finally got cleared in customs. In Bucharest, and I think it's starting to make its way over to her. And mine, the one that my mom sent me, is in New York since December, I don't know, 11, I don't know, very early December. It's just been stuck in New York, and it's really frustrating with the mail, but otherwise we're good, you know. What can you do? Can't complain. I mean, you can, but it really doesn't help. If only complaining helped, Anjan, I would complain all day. I'd be master complainer, but it doesn't. So I just try to shut my mouth as often as I can. You know? Yeah. I don't know what's happening. And not even overseas, not even like international packages, but yeah, we were supposed to, even USPS is crazy here, like within the country. It's just been like rogue USPS delivering to the wrong address and me never getting my packages that I order. Is just crazy. I don't know what is up with them. Just like they stopped caring, you know. Rogue mail, it really is. Yes. Yep. It's just, I feel the same. I feel that lately, I don't know when it started, but lately everybody's just not giving a crap about what they do anymore. Not artists, of course, because artists always care, but everybody else. Yeah. Well, you know, I don't want to say I'm glad, but in a way I'm glad that I'm not like, I thought it was something seriously wrong with me. That why are things happening to me? But if it's everywhere, then it's all right. Right. That's why people get together. And Jen, that's why. So they know they're not alone in their troubles. It's Schadenfreude. I'm perfectly convinced that people just get together to say, hey, you know, I have troubles too, don't worry. Commiserating. Right. That is it. Living codependently in misery. Commiserating. It's funny. Misery loves company. Isn't that right? Yep. You've put your finger right on it. It does? Well, I'm so glad you like it. I think I'm just about done with it. I'm emotionally just about done with it. Which is how artists finish their work. I'm emotionally finished. It is officially finished. To be honest, I think it looks better in the picture than in real life, but I'll take it. It always looks better to the person that didn't do it. I know that for a fact. Alright, Anjan, thank you so much for stopping by. You bring smiles to my heart and soul. Hope to see you soon. Mwah. And enjoy your weekend. I will send my love accordingly. This is it for now. I don't know exactly what else needed to have one of these rubies. I would put one in the middle there. I think that would be cool to just break the monotony a little bit. I think there should be one here, right here. How's that? Let's see how it looks. It is huge. It is huge. Let me take my muffs off. There we go. This is humongous. Hang on. It's so echoing here. All right. Well, this is it. Thank you for joining me. And this is how it looks in the back. I'll probably give it another coat to make it look all flat and perfect, but all in all, not so bad, you know. Thank you for watching and have a wonderful weekend. I will see you later. No, this way is better. I'll see you later this way. All right. There we go. Bye-bye.